Run around here. We're
We'd like to welcome you to the Bare Knuckle Fighting Championship Presser presented by Fusion CBD Sports Water. It's all the benefits you need for fast muscle recovery. You can visit cbdproducts.com for more.
Awesome. Yeah, thank you so much. And obviously, I'm really excited to be here and officially be a part of the family. I've spoken about it, and this has been in talks ever since I was a free agent. So this is kind of where I felt the most passionate about. And then it completely lined up with what I wanted and what they wanted. And we were able to really create a happy partnership. And I do think we're both very excited. It's a win-win for both of us. And I can't wait to get my first matchup, and we're already in talks of when that might be. And super excited about the opportunity. And I hope to be a part of your guys' family, not only just in my fights, but also outside of it. And I think you'll see a lot of me around the BKFC family. So thank you.
After a long, highly successful career at UFC, what led you to Bare Knuckle Fighting Championship?
When you do something for such a long time, you know, it became kind of routine. You know, I already knew what to do when I get there on Monday, you know, went through the whole process. So I wasn't as excited as I am right now, you know, to compete in this new sport. You know, it's a badass organization. You know, I'm excited to get up there and, you know, throw knuckles. I think that's going to be exciting. You know, the way I see it, it's like I'm walking, you know, with my wife, somebody try to, you know, grab her butt or something. You know, we're going to have to throw it down. So that's, you know, that's exactly how I feel right now. You know, it's bare knuckles. My thumb is protected, you know, so let's freaking go. Being used to 5-15 minutes of high pace, you know, and then you cut it down to 2 minutes with 1 minute rest in between. Let's go, you know. So I don't know how it's going to play out. That's just the reality of it. I know I'm going to be ready to throw down 10 minutes, and I know Phil is going to come ready too. So I know somebody's going to get knocked the F out.
What are you doing to prepare your hands? You have the most experience out of everybody at the table with one fight in BKFC. Was there anything you did for your last fight as far as...
If he breaks. What else are you going to do?
It's amazing to be able to spark my passion again, and I think you're going to be able to see that. And it is so true. Like, you know, as a fighter, we love to throw hands. I just want to go punch somebody, and that's what we get to do. You don't have to think about all the other things and the other variables. This is like basic math for me, and I'm excited to show off my skill.
Paige, you said earlier that your heart was in Bare Knuckle Fighting Championship the whole time. What led you to Bare Knuckle Fighting Championship? Why? Why was that in your heart?
Yeah, so, you know, ultimately I knew there would be a few big players in the game when I became a free agent. And I had a mutual friend, Sean Wheelock, who works with BKFC, and he gave me a call. And we had worked together. We'd commentated in the past. And he actually asked me if I would ever want to commentate alongside him. And I, of course, was excited about the opportunity. Unfortunately, it never happened. But then he called again when I was a free agent and said, hey, I want you to join BKFC for sure, like full time. So, you know, I looked at the organization, I saw what they stood for. And, you know, with my MMA career, you know, I was very accomplished. I was in the UFC for almost 6 years. And now I feel like it's the perfect opportunity to open that next chapter. And it's not necessarily a move backwards for me. It's a move laterally. It's a whole new obstacle. It's a new opportunity for me. And that's what really excites me. And it's true. No, I'm not the veteran that Thiago is. But in the UFC, I am a veteran. It did become repetitive. Whereas this, I'm so excited. And, like, the nerves are already set in of what it's going to be like on my first fight, and I'm excited for that.
It's something new, you know. I've been around for a very long time. You know, I fought for the belt. I was 25 years old, and I was a kid. I came here, I was 19 years old. I spoke no English. I had $50 in my name, you know, so everything happened very fast for me, you know. And when I caught myself, you know, thing kind of passed. I had a lot of injuries, you know. It was a awesome journey, you know, but I'm excited now that I have kind of like a new beginning, you know, in this badass organization. You know, I know better. I know my mistakes that I've done in the past, and I'm excited to be here, to be a part of this, you know, to help grow this sport, to grow this business. And I want to make history, you know. I'm ready for violence. I'm ready for blood, you know. I was talking to Paige, you know, if you look good, you look good. So I'm not worried about cuts or anything. And at the end of the day, it's South Florida. We have a lot of great plastic surgeons in here. So, you know, if you guys see me at the end of my career with hair, you know, that's kind of blonde, don't judge me. You know, but all jokes aside, I'm ready, I'm excited, you know, and I'm here to become a champion.
In August of 2020. Soon, champ. Let's go, champ. Shannon Briggs in the house.
Any promotion wants you on any of their cards. What makes this now, okay, for you something that you want to do? I mean, that you're looking forward to, because I see you're antsy about it, okay? And you love the experience, but go ahead.
Like I said, I don't feel old.
I didn't say you're old.
When I feel old, trust me, I won't do this, because trust me, I have a bunch of shit going on. I'm super smart, believe me. But yeah, I feel good, and as long as I feel good, I'm gonna do it.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know, man. These guys in bare knuckle are a different kind of beast. I mean, I think we're bad. You know, MMA fighters are, you know, badasses, but to get punched with some knuckles, it takes a different type of mentality to like that. And I don't like getting hit. So we'll see. We'll see. I respect the hell out of each and every individual up here, because it takes a lot of heart and pride and just toughness to be up here. You know, I'm trying to find the right words to fit these caliber athletes. I can describe an MMA fighter and what they're about. These bare knuckle fighters right here, dude, are just something different. They're crazy, you know, but I like crazy. And the world is crazy right now, so why not join everything and have some fun and give some people, join the movement of craziness and just have some fun. You know what I mean? Let everybody, this MMA and sports is what brings society together. So we need this, you know what I'm saying? So you get people some entertainment, some teeth missing, some blood flying everywhere. It brings them happiness, you know what I'm saying? So why not give it to them with bare knuckle fighting?
What's been going on behind the scenes during this pandemic that you've been able to forge forward and get all this stuff done?
We were just moving so fast. I think we had a chance, you know, to really regroup and focus on where we wanted to go and not just enjoying the ride. And we focused on where we wanted to go. And, you know, it's been great to be a part. It's been great to be an upstart organization. And now it's great to be a big player in the major organizations. And that's what we are. You know, we put on some great, great fights. We're competing for some of the biggest free agents in combat sports right now. And I think now is our time. And I think that, like I said, in 2 years from now, they're going to say, instead of saying, oh, one show, they're done. Oh, they're a fluke. Oh, they're not going to be around. To holy shit, Bare Knuckle Fighting Championship just took over. And that's what's going to happen.
Ashley had a question. What is up with that fake-ass belt over there, man?
Come take it. You don't like it? Come take it. You know your belt ain't worth nothing?
I want to see the heat. Bring it out, baby. Who is the champ? Who is the champ?
What were you around?
I only got one question.
What's the question, champ?
Where were you when we were supposed to fight? What happened?
No, hold on. Round two of the tournament. Hey, you're going to fight Jim. Jim's like, if I'm going to fight Palomino, I'm going to do it for the title. They put the title on the line.
What?
They put the title on the line, and what he does? He don't show up.
Come on. What happened? Why you ain't show up, champ? So what happened? Give him the mic. What happened? Tell what happened.
Let's make this fight happen.
Oh, no answer. Oh, there's no answer. There's no answer to that.
Only someone who knows they ain't the champ.
TV as well.
We've been ready. We've been ready since the second round of the tournament where he said no. And then we were ready when this was up for grabs and he said no. And so, what are you barking about? Ain't about that life, man.
Good to see you. Good to see you, my man.
All right, bro.
Thank you, guys. Good to see you, man.